A lot of aspiring musicians really believe that getting signed means that they have made it. The physical act of signing a record contract will set them on the way to fame, riches, and drinking bonus Cristal at the Grammys. Here's what's more likely to happen. On the back of a spurious buzz from the music press, a few packed gigs in tiny clubs, and a couple of late night radio plays, some idiot like Rob Hastings offers you a record deal for, oh, let's say 100 grand. Great, you now owe us 100 grand. You pack your job in Quadrophenia style and take your parents out for a slap-up meal where you tell them you'll never work again. You leave Bolton or wherever and get the train to Euston thinking to yourself, I am the fucking king. You're keen to get cracking your debut album, however, the odds are that it will take the A&R man months to make up his mind about a producer. He will then, inevitably, choose the wrong one. This guy will spend 2 or 3 months destroying what little talent you had to begin with, and then you're back to square one. Not content with picking the wrong producer the first time, the A&R guy will pick the wrong producer a couple more times. By the time you've gone through this process 3 times, it's a year down the line, the record still isn't finished, and your initial recording budget has tripled to £300,000. You now owe us £400,000. By the time we finally get a single released, your great friends over at Press and Radio can no longer give a good drop of spunk if you're dead or alive. They liked you a year ago. They've got new bands to play with now. In fact, I'll go you one further. The music press actually hates you now. You've gone from being the next Sex Pistols to the last Black Lace in 12 short months. So, you get zero airplay and just a tiny smattering of reviews in places like the Aberdeenshire Gazette and the North Wales Chronicle, both of whom love the single. Unfortunately, no one who reads these papers is aged under 65 or lives within 100 miles of a chart return shop. In an attempt to rebuild your profile, we send you back out on the road. But you've got a record company behind you now. Why would you travel in a transit van like the old days? So, you get a fucking great tour bus the size of an aircraft carrier, 6 totally superfluous roadies, an outlandish catering company run by a pair of titless Notting Hill dykes, and a light show with the equivalent power of the fucking sun. Unfortunately, you're still selling zero records and playing tiny venues. However, the roadies, aircraft carrier, titless dyke, sun combo is costing something like 5 grand a fucking day. But hey, we still believe in the band, man, so we underwrite the shortfall. You play 20 dates, losing thousands every night, bringing your debt up to us up to something like £500,000. Finally, we release your debut album. The NME expends 100 words and no photograph to call it undiluted piss. We optimistically press 5,000 copies. We sell 700 in the first week, and then 200 in the second, and then, well, that's it. No more. Not another copy troubles a chart return machine anywhere in the world ever. Thanks to a combination of your mediocrity and our gross incompetence, your debut LP, the crystallization of all the energy, insight, and ambition of your young life, has sold 900 copies. With retail discounts, you've generated maybe £4,000 worth of income. You are finished. Game over. You're 22 years old and £600,000 in debt to us, a bunch of subhuman demons who were your best friends a year ago, but who would now gladly slit your throat and dance around in your fucking blood if we thought it would help us claw back a single penny of your debt.
How far? How far are you willing to go? Hello! You win last 10 minutes.